Welcome to the Automation Show on the SubTube channel. My name is Sjoerd Libbers and I will be your host for today. We are going to implement SAP SNC today on a sandbox environment. We're going to do that in two steps. We're going to go through some slides and then we're getting our hands dirty and activate SNC ourselves. So it's going to be nice to do. Let's get started. Yes, let's go to the next slide. When the SAP GUI wants to connect to a SAP ABAP system, this is done through the DIAG protocol, which is a proprietary protocol from SAP itself. It contains the data that's sent back and forth all the time. This is unencrypted data, and this means that a thief could look to the data on the network and see your username, server name, and worst of all, your password. It's going unencrypted, it's not even hashed, it's going unencrypted over the line, so it's so you need to protect it. This is being done by activating SAP SNC, which is a very easy procedure, and I'm going to show you it in a minute. By activating it, thieves can no longer look into your packages. What are the steps that we need to take? We will use SNC Wizard to set all parameters and guide us through some other steps. We will create a SAP CryptoLib, which is part of the wizard. We will import our certificate on our desktop. So the certificate is trusted that we use. And then we're going to restart our SAP system. And we're going to demonstrate that the connection is now secure. And we will see that by a little lock that is presented in the GUI. It's the same as in a web browser where you see a lock that the connection is encrypted and secured, and it's the same within the SAP GUI. We don't have any AD setup, so that's not needed. We don't need any secure login server, and basic encryption is free from an SAP license point of view. So let's get started with step one. Let's dive into the screen and continue. Yes, let's get started. Let's open SAPlogon. Let's open our FES system, log in with my own user ID. Let's have a look at Trust first. It's still empty, our SAP CryptoLib, SNC SAP CryptoLib. And let's start the SNC wizard, which will guide us through our implementation. If you don't, if it doesn't work, the wizard is just setting some parameters and configuring as Trust, so it's not that difficult to do by hand, but let's use the wizard anyway. Our identity will be, common name is SBF. You can put anything in there you want, make it as difficult as you want, doesn't matter. These are the settings that will be set on the operating system in the profile, so don't forget to import them later on. We have to restart, okay. Let's create a PSE. It's already created automatically. So we can go back and we can say, okay, complete it. It's that easy. It's that easy. How easy was that? Oh, it's amazing. It's amazing. How easy was that? Let's look at the OS. Okay, here we're logged in. Let's go look in the profiles. VI. Okay, here you see all the settings that have been created. SNC will be enabled. And this is our common name. And we need this also in our SAP GUI. So I'll just copy it and we'll create a new entry in our SAP logon. So we're going to say here, okay, let's make a new entry. And we're going to call this FES SNC system ID sandbox FES 00. And the application server was netweaver fes.ems8.lab. Now we're going to say, okay, we're going to use SAP SNC, but we're going to use username and password. Okay, as you can see, if I now try it, it will not work. First of all, there are two steps that we need to do. One is we have to restart the system to activate the settings. So we can start with that. And second is we have to export the certificate from our PSE and import it into our machine where SAP GUI runs. So we have to wait a little bit. Yes, and let's start it. And let's wait a little while until it gets started. Okay, it seems to have started. So let's go back to our. It will still not work. We now get a peer certification, peer certificate verification failed, and that's because we cannot trust the certificate yet. So we're gonna log on using our username and password. During an unsecure session, you can see that here there is a lock which is open, means it's unsecure, so everyone on this network can see my password. But it's no surprise that there is no one on this network, so I can do this pretty safely. Okay, we're logged in. I'm gonna export the certificate. Let's go to S-Trust. Go to our certificate. And try to export it. You can also sign your own certificate there, or have it signed by someone else. And maybe by the company you work for. And if that's a root certificate that's already trusted, then you don't have to do this anymore. But okay, let's save it on the desktop. So we'll make it SBF certificate. Okay. Okay, that's fine. Yes. Okay, so now we exported the certificate. We're gonna open the Certificate Explorer, going to the Start menu. And this is what you then get. So we go to import the certificate as root authorities. That's the basis certificering instances. That's the root trusted root certificates. So we're gonna import a certificate. So we're gonna select it. Click on Browse. CBF certificate, open, next, finish. Importing has been finished. So now it should be in here somewhere. There it is, the SBF, so it's now trusted. I also have my own root certificate. I could add this one there as well, but I'm not gonna do that in this video. Okay, so this is it. So now it should work actually. So let's close this one. And let's start our SNC version now. Yeah! And there you go. It has a lock. So it's now secure to put in. So now I will use my my very secret password. I'm already logged on, but it doesn't matter. Logged on by the other GUI. And I'm logged on now securely. So every time my password goes over the line now, or any data, it's encrypted. Exactly what we want. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you liked it, please give a thumbs up. That's good for the YouTube algorithm. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.